चैंबर के अध्यक्ष श्री गोपाल जी और आज के कार्यक्रम के संयोजक श्री रवि विग जी, श्रीमान अनिल खेतान जी और मेरे से पहले वक्ता और आदरणीय महेश शर्मा जी और आलोक जी और मंच पर सभी माननीय पीएचडी के पदाधिकारी गण और यहाँ पर उपस्थित भाइयों और बहनों, वी हैव ऑलरेडी लिसन टू ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड थॉट प्रोवोकिंग I call it as a keynote address of today's seminar. And I also understand now the time constraint. Very important people. We have been here for the last two and a half hours listening to various views on this subject, integral humanism. I want to touch 3-4 aspects because different dimensions have been covered already. Today, the government is run by BJP under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji. Deen Dayal Upadhyaya, the person who has introduced this concept to the Indian polity, he is seen as a mentor for the political thought of Bharatiya Janata Party. Now we are celebrating the centenary year of Deen Dayal Upadhyaya. So there is an interest in the industry and there is an interest in various countries also. What is the economic philosophy and what is the thinking of the present day leadership which is running the government? How it is different from the other parties? Or how it is different from other governments, whether it is here or outside? Because Mahesh ji ne jo kaha shreshti aur sab baniya jo bhi hain, ye to achhi cheez hai. Lekin the most important aspect for the businessman is he cannot be divorced from the present day reality. जो वर्तमान है उससे वो हटकर सोच नहीं सकता. एक दार्शनिक उससे हटकर सोच सकता है और वो हो सकता है कि दार्शनिक ने जो सोचा है, जो देखा है, उसको धरती पर आने में 200 साल लग सकता है, 25 साल भी लग सकता है, लेकिन व्यापार जिसको व्यापार करना है या इंडस्ट्री जिसको चलाना है उसको हैज टू डील विद द प्रेजेंट, whether it is good or bad, whether it is Aurangzeb or Shivaji, he has to deal with it. So, isliye, now, what is the difference? How things are different for this party and leadership? This is the question for every businessman. And we know, we all understand that we are living in a kind of setup where any political party, which whatever may be the ideology, whatever may be their thinking, we also have to live with the continuity principle. You cannot just change the canvas and put a different canvas and start the whole thing new. So these are the things which we have to take into consideration and we have to see. Now, Indian society is functioning, and Indian society is functioning not necessarily as ordained by the present day government, or I am not talking about this government, any government. Society and people, they are living by their principles, their concept of the life and everything. In India, whether Nehru ruled or Gandhi ruled or anybody ruled, we have a different, you know, society which has got different layers. Whether we live under the communist rule, or live under the BJP rule, live under the Congress rule, or live under the English rule, whatever, Mughal rule. The philosophy of each Indian, every Indian, has not much changed. They know all these things. This Advaita philosophy, the Advaita concept of the human being, the all is one. Not all are one, all is one. This division is seen always as ignorance. Is because of the duality, is because of ignorance. When you understand the underlying unity, then that is called as wisdom. And if you are not able to see that unity, then the duality is seen always as a sign of the ignorance. This is wherever you go, educated, uneducated, literate, illiterate, labor or working class person or industrialist, this kind of concept you come to know in every village and in every locality and in every place. So they know the Indian philosophy. So what Dindayalji has said or presented to the world is not new, which he has discovered from nowhere. He has collected from the Indian practices, Indian traditions and Indian concepts, with which we are all aware. Even my grandmother or your grandmother, who have taught to you and me, everybody, the same thing. Sometimes spiritual traditions or sects may differ, but this kind of philosophy is taught here in this country, in this, here. This may not be the same in different societies. But, you know, even this philosophy is functioning. Now I come to the important point. This philosophy is the basic thing which is now driving the Indian society, irrespective of the kind of state we have, irrespective of the government we have. Some sections, some individuals, some families, we may have Bhogavadi, but the ideal with which this society has lived is not Bhogavadi. Restrained consumption has always been the guiding principle or cherished ideal for even all important business people. You go to Rajasthani traditional businessman, or go to Gujarati traditional businessman, or go to Tamil Nadu Chettiar traditional businessman. Even today, the traditional businessman, when I am saying even today to family, the values with which they live are not so different from the values we read and we in the books and all. So these are the, there may be deviations. Even I may be preaching, But in my life I may have some deviations. It doesn't mean that my preaching has become irrelevant. You know, the important point is I believe, I preach, but in practice sometimes there may be deviations, but I would love to, given a chance, I would love to. So this is there among different sections, different families. That is creating and that is becoming the dynamism of the present day economy. We have savings in India. What is the basis of Indian savings which we have today in our economy? 25%, 27%, 28%, 30%, 32% of the GDP is now in Indian savings. We don't have other societies having the same kind of savings. Society is always seen as, you know, poor people society, middle class people society. But this society, how it has acquired this quality and how it is helping the Indian economy. If we understand this, then we come to integral humanism or the concept of that responsibility, the concept of oneness. That value system is helping the families to save more and consume less. Go for restrained consumption, which has been institutionalized in the society. This kind of value system is institutionalized in the form of family, in the form of caste, in the form of society. So that is creating an encouraging ecosystem to have the savings. If we do not have this kind of society, if we did not have this kind of society and savings, the Indian state of present in the after 1947 would not have been able to drive the Indian growth and Indian development. So savings of the society are coming mainly because of this value system which we have. And in my view, this is going to be the important stimulus or important growth point for the future development. So this we have to understand. And this is making India less dependent on the foreign resources. India's dependence on foreign resources compared to any other country is minimum. Compared to the kind of population we have, compared to capital formation requirements we have, compared to investment requirements we have, if you take all these things, our dependence on the foreign resources is minimum compared to any other country, just because the Indian savings are more, and Indian savings are more because the Indian lifestyle and Indian concept of world or concept of family. So this is going to remain with us as source of strength. This is what I call this integral humanism in functioning. Integral humanism in book, we may be discussing, but integral humanism is in functioning, which we have. This is very important thing. Now the second important thing which I would like to, the social responsibility. Very important thing. Ultimately, chor aur ye jo modern terms hain, corruption, chor, ye sab cheeze apni jagah important hai, isko discuss karenge, governance ki jagah. Lekin, ultimate chor Balaji se nahi hota hai na, Vaishnav Devi se nahi hota, koi aadmi. Jahan baithe hue sab log, bas sarkar chor kahe chal sakta hai. Usko koi dikkat nahi hai. Wo ladai ladega. Usko ye manta hi nahi hai na, sarkar hai. सरकार तो वो है ठाकुर. तो इसलिए जब तक उनके मन में लगेगा कि भाई ये चोर नहीं है, तो उनको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. तो जब तक वो धर्मशाला बनाएगा, मंदिर बनाएगा, सड़क बनाएगा, बच्चों को पढ़ावे के लिए कुछ देगा, एज लॉन्ग एज द सोशल रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज आर डिस्चार्ज्ड बाय ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन, देन the problem of taxation, don't view it in the context of ethical and unethical. क्योंकि एथिक्स एंड अनएथिक्स एज लॉन्ग एज द स्टेट इज नॉट एथिकल द टैक्सेशन डज नॉट बिकम एथिकल. व्हेन स्टेट बिकम्स एथिकल देन ओनली टैक्सेशन बिकम्स एथिकल. When state acquires the moral authority, moral power and moral the values as a core, then only the taxation becomes the moral. As long as the state is bereft of moral values, morality, then the state may use the penalizing authority as a coercive authority, but it will not have that moral power. So I will go into that aspect, but in India, society is functioning even today because of this morality, because of this sense of responsibility, sense of functioning. Politics in India, after 1947, still they have not acquired the kind of moral power which is required. That is the reason it lacks participation. It lacks participation not just in taxation, it lacks participation in every work, in every act of governance. गांव में सड़क बनाने में भी मेरे सड़क का फीलिंग नहीं है, तालाब बनाने में मेरे तालाब का फीलिंग नहीं है. स्वच्छ गांव रखना है तो मेरा गांव है स्वच्छ गांव रखने का फीलिंग नहीं, क्योंकि इट लैक्स पार्टिसिपेशन. तो वो प्रॉब्लम एक दूसरे को गाली देते हुए चल सकते हैं, वो तो चलेंगे कुछ दिन, लेकिन कुल मिलाकर के मेरा तो कहना है कि देश में जो इंडियन वैल्यूज जिसको विचार इंटीग्रल विच रिप्रेजेंट्स दैट अद्वैता दैट वननेस is still living, still functioning, still driving almost all important dimensions of the social and individual activity. So we are not working in a vacuum. This we have to understand. Now the third important thing which I want to say here is, after 1947, you know, we got independence. But slowly the different limbs of Indian society is reasserting and becoming active. So Indian polity is getting Indianized, Indian governance is also getting Indianized, and everything will get, after 50 or 70 years, the Indian governance will not be the governance like America. It cannot be. It is impossible. Because our requirements, our experience are going to be different. Now, I come to the industry. You know, whatever may be the idea, finance ministers or governments or prime ministers, they, you know, they keep changing. Society is not going to change according to the... Congress party had passed a resolution in our... that we will we should go for the cooperative farming. You know, Nehru wanted it. Cooperative farming means this agriculture land holdings owned by the private individuals, means farmers.
It should not be. And Congress got attracted to the cooperative farming or this farming communes of the Russia. So they wanted to introduce, they passed the political resolution, but they could not implement because the Indian society would not have accepted. So Indian society is entrepreneurial society. And this entrepreneurial society is not going to change, it will change this character of the state if it is alien, if it is foreign, if it is implanted, if it is imposed, it will fight, it will not accept. Sometimes, you know, the PhD Chamber of Commerce leadership, because, I was told that I was going to be a good person. It is a cutting across. इंडिया में सब जगह यूनिटी सिंबल है, गुप्त गुप्ता, यहाँ गुप्त है, गुप्ता है, तो पूरी व्यापारिक समाज में सरनेम है
गुप्ता श्रीलिंग,
गुप्ता श्रीलिंग और गुप्त पुल्लिंग, तो दोनों गुप्त है। तो पीएचडी चैम्बर ऑफ कॉमर्स व्हाइल एक्सप्रेसिंग इट्स ओपिनियन मे नॉट एक्सप्रेस द वे आई एक्सप्रेस एज अ पॉलिटिशियन। डिसएग्रीमेंट If I have with the state, if I have with the government, if I have the political philosophy, I express in a different way, but do express in a different way. It doesn't mean that you are accepting. So, any effort to make this India as a differently oriented entrepreneurial society, we will not accept it. It is basically an entrepreneurial society, India. So, in India, if you come with a different philosophy, that is not going to work. So, we have to understand this. In coming days, integral humanism means encouragement to entrepreneurship. Encouragement to entrepreneurship is going to be the benchmark, litmus test, whether integral humanism is working, functioning or not. Not just because of BJP leadership is saying that. No. Important thing is India. Indian society is standing. And India could become number one in the past only because of this. India will become number one after 10 years, 50 years, or 20 years. It will become number one again because of this. And Indian entrepreneurship means it's a creative mind. It ultimately you will have big industry. You will have big industry. 5 people, 10 people dominating not just India, but the whole world with. But you will have now 38 lakh small scale industry units. Again, it will become much more. So, industry, entrepreneurs, small entrepreneurs driving the Indian economy, it will remain as a bedrock. So the litmus test of the economic policy and the growth story will be decided and determined by this. How much encouragement is given by this government or state and the policies, whether they are in tune with integral humanism or not, this is going to be the important issue which I want to. So now I am coming to a point, Indian growth story. If you are visualizing like this, then there small industry dominating, some small industry becoming more and more vibrant and dynamic. So the policies must have to be in tune with this kind of trend. And another point I want to make here is employment issue. Is no entrepreneurship and employment
in India, Indian variety. American variety of entrepreneurship is no entrepreneurship. It will not work in India. So, Indian variety of entrepreneurship and employment. Now, 13 million people every year adding to the labor market. You are creating a growth. But if you are not involving, if you do not involve the people in the work, then growth becomes a liability, unsustainable. Before becoming unsustainable at the economic level, it will become unsustainable at the political level. This we have to understand, and there is no party and no leader, particularly the present government, if you take commitment to democracy is philosophical and it is ideological and it is political and everything. Commitment to democracy. There may be some small here and there some discussions, whatever it may be, but commitment to this democracy is. So, commitment to democracy is final, then Any economic idea must have to be sustainable, politically sustainable. So, inclusive growth, sabka saath, sabka vikas, in terms of employment and in terms of entrepreneurship, that is going to create a sustainable variety of economic paradigm, where employment is ensured. And, you know, in integral humanism, what is the ideal concept of employment? That is, Mahesh has discussed to some extent, we can discuss afterwards. According to the taste, according to the internal, inner voice and inner urge, the purpose of the life must have to be fulfilling. So that is okay, but even minimum level, so this inclusive or the participatory growth is essential. So this government is also conscious about that. Now coming to the make in India, whether it is going to help or not, it will be judged by this aspect. We have got so many clusters. We have got so many industrial clusters and groups and sectors and all these things. Now, Indian market is becoming a driving point for others' growth, and we are not able to have the, you know, same thing as a stimulus working for our growth. We have the large army. We have this kind of imports. How long you will continue to have the kind of imports and continue to entertain an idea that you will become one day a Security Council member? You want to. Becoming Security Council member is not just a privilege, not just entitlement, it is a kind of responsibility. This kind of population remaining outside the global administration and having the stability and the peace all over the world, it is impossible. The concept of independence, the concept of freedom is not going to allow this. So in such a situation, India becoming a Security Council member, aiming to, or pleading for, advocating for, and now thinking that continue to import this kind of arms and ammunition and continue to have the employment here, all these are not going to work. So ultimately, this requirement, this demand has to help the first Indian entrepreneur, second Indian employment requirement, third India's security requirements. So integral humanism, when we say, it is not just philosophical, it is political and it is economical and it is, you know, something to do with the everyday life of the nation. So this make in India concept is not just simple a political slogan, it cannot be and it has to become. Now, there are some problems. I understand when somebody says chore and not and all these things. I understand the feeling, and I also understand sometimes the inner hurt. You know, we should not take it in that way. Ultimately, this Indian society has got two accounts everybody is accepting. How long we would like to continue with these two accounts? I am not saying that in the next 1 year this should go away. I we have lived, ultimately Akbar also has come, gone. Aurangzeb also has come, gone. And English people also, Portuguese, all these people have come and gone. Some people may say, well, these parties also will come and go and India will remain like this. Maybe people may be thinking. But ultimately, as entrepreneurs, how long we would like to have this kind of duality in our life? Personal life and collective life. A personal life or the nation's life. How long we would like to have? So there must have to be effort. And effort is there with a good intention. Not with any kind of personal or the party's narrow agenda. There may be certainly some lapses, some shortcomings. Ultimately, you are working in the system, you are utilizing the same instruments, same vehicles. So definitely, some problems may be there, some conflicts may be there, some distortions may be there. It doesn't mean that it is aimed for, it is not aimed for the cleansing. We have to, this you ultimately emerging as a powerful country and emerging as a powerful citizen with a clean heart, clean mind and clean thinking, somewhere you have to create institutions. And in order to create such institutional system, somewhere you have to create this kind of efforts. So it is for the removal of the duality. It's not a dignified thing for anybody. Nobody, no respective. Ultimately, entrepreneurs' prime urge is not to have two accounts. Entrepreneurs' prime urge is to express himself, his entrepreneurial qualities, skills, capacities. The prime urge is that. Every entrepreneur, wherever I go, say this kind of corruption, this harassment, and the kind of strangulating ecosystem, everybody suffers. So, we have to. And somewhere, you know, the kind of effort which has been now taken, it is a no looking back approach. You cannot look back. It is impossible for any government and any leader now to look back, because the kind of drive you have created, this drive is not going to allow any leader, any party, anybody to stop in between. I am 100% sure the political reforms will have to come in. It is impossible to have a bad polity to have a good economy. Political parties living with the dual accounts and expecting the business to have the single account, it is impossible. So, it is not years, it is months only, you will be seeing a competitive atmosphere in politics. If somebody is lagging, somebody will be taking forward, overtaking. So a competitive atmosphere is going to come into the politics to have the single account in politics. So in my view, all these things are going to create a kind of polity which is required to help the Indian economy. I am happy the philosophical aspects are discussed by Maheshji, so I have not again gone into those things. And all of you are definitely interested in the political party and government and priorities. And another point I would like to, you know, just mention, socialism in the form of statism is foreign to integral humanism. And it is unacceptable to integral humanism, which I already cleared. So now there is a class consciousness that poor people are happy now. Government is talking about the taking the money from the rich. You know, it does not mean this 1971 Garibi Hatao. It is not going to be the statism. Statism is completely foreign. It will be a positive, pro-active for the entrepreneurship. मैं कल पहले PhD चैम्बर में भी रवि जी आपने एक बार बुलाया था तो मैंने एक मीटिंग में बोला था स्टेटिज्म एंड सोशलिज्म आर सेम और स्टेटिज्म एंड सोशलिज्म इस देश में इंस्टीट्यूशनल फॉर्म्स में पूरी रशिया और चाइना के जैसे नहीं हुआ होगा लेकिन माइंड पे कुछ साल इतना जबरदस्त हावी रहा तो मैंने एक बार बताया कि इंडियन फिल्म्स वेदर इट इज हिंदी फिल्म्स तमिल फिल्म्स और तेलुगु फिल्म्स सारे फिल्म्स में एक हमेशा थीम होता है जो जो इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट है वो ब्लैक मार्केटिंग होता है, हा? और वो माफिया होता है, वो चोर होता है। अब कोई भी फिल्म है उसमें विलन होता है वो। फिर उसका बेटी जो है बड़ा खूबसूरत हीरोइन होती है, और उसका कार एक्सेप्टेबल होता है, बहुत बड़ा कार, और वो कार का जो ड्राइवर होता है वो कई बार हीरो होता है, और जो लेबर होता है या वर्किंग फैक्ट्री में वो हीरो होता है। वो विलन को पिटाई करता है और हीरोइन को लेता है। दिस इज द थीम। और ये इंडिया में इस प्रकार से इस कदर छाया रहा तो सोशलिज्म का जो इंटेलेक्चुअल एस्टैब्लिशमेंट डेनिग्रेटिंग वेल्थ, डेनिग्रेटिंग द एंटरप्रेन्योर, इसमें जिस पैमाने पर रहा उस पैमाने पर मेरे पार्टी तो इसके विरोध में पहले से रही। तो इसलिए ये जो अभी जो भी कुछ एफर्ट्स है वो इट डज नॉट मीन दैट कि वो कोई स्टेटिज्म और स्टेट कंट्रोल्ड और स्टेट सेंट्रिक वेलफेयरिज्म भी नहीं होगा, बट वी कैन नॉट इग्नोर द वेलफेयर एंड सोशल सिक्योरिटी एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द पीपल। कि भाई जितने इस देश में अनइंश्योर्ड है, जितने इस देश में वल्नरेबल सेक्शंस हैं, इसमें डेमोक्रेसी को आप आगे ले जाते हैं, पॉलिटिक्स को आप आगे ले जाते हैं, तो प्राइवेट सेक्टर अगर विलिंग नहीं है और उतना फास्ट नहीं है तो स्टेट के नॉट वेट, स्टेट हैज टू क्रिएट सम एक्टिविज्म। तो इसलिए वेलफेयर चीजों को आगे लेना पड़ता है, तो समडे इट विल बी अगेन ट्रांसफर टू द सोसाइटी, क्योंकि सोसाइटी में जितने लिम्ब्स हैं वो डायनेमिक हैं। तो वो आने वाले दिनों में, क्योंकि मेरे विश्वास है कि इंडियन सोसाइटी, भारतीय समाज एकात्म मानव दर्शन के विचारों पर विश्वास रखने वाला समाज है। विश्व में इस प्रकार के समाज को बनाना बड़ा मुश्किल होता है, क्योंकि समाज के नॉट बी क्रिएटेड बाय वन जनरेशन और वन स्टेट और वन गवर्नमेंट और वन लीडर। ये 5000 सालों की ऋषि मुनि तपस्वी पराक्रमी योद्धा समाजवाद समाज सेवक ऐसे सुधारक इतने लोगों के कारण से ये सब चीजें ये समाज में आया है। अमेरिकन सोसाइटी ऐसा नहीं है या अन्य सोसाइटीज ऐसे नहीं है। सो वी हैव ए गुड सोसाइटी एंड विच इज लिविंग बाई द वैल्यूज एंड आइडियल्स ऑफ इंटीग्रल ह्यूमनिज्म मोस्टली। Definitely we have some distortions within the society as we have distortions individually in our life, and we are conscious, and if we are not conscious there is an effort to make us conscious and there will be corrections. So state within this Indian framework, within this Indian integral humanistic framework, state will be a very important tool, but it will not be a monopoly tool. Thank you.